Savitri, Book 2, Canto 10, The Kingdoms and Godheads of the Little Mind, page number 250. And the geometric curves of her time plan, she multiplied her slow half-course at truth. Impatient of enigma and the unknown, intolerant of the lawless and unique, imposing reflection on the march of force, imposing clarity on the unfathomable, she strove to reduce to rules the mystic world, nothing she knew but all things hoped to know. In dark inconscient realms once void of thought, missioned by supreme intelligence, to throw its ray upon the obscure vast, an imperfect light leading an erring mass, by the power of sense and the idea and word, she ferrets out nature's process, substance, cause, all life to harmonize by thought's control. She with the huge imbroglio struggles still, ignorant of all but her own seeking mind, to save the world from ignorance she came, a sovereign worker through the centuries, observing and remolding all that is. Confident she took off her stupendous charge, there the low bend and mighty figure sits, bowed under the arc lamps of her factory home, amid the clatter and ringing of her tools. A rigorous stare in her creative eyes, coercing the plastic stuff of cosmic mind, she sets the hard inventions of her brain in a pattern of eternal fixity, indifferent to the cosmic dumb demand, unconscious of true close realities, of the unspoken thought, the voiceless heart, she leans to forge her credos and iron cords, and metal structures to imprison life, and mechanic models of all things that are. For the world seen, she weaves a world conceived, she spins in strip but unsubstantial lines, she spins in strip but unsubstantial lines. Om Savitri, Om Savitri, Om Savitri.